There were reports recently about possibly joining Sam Allardyce at Sunderland. Is that something that could happen, or is it a bit too soon?
No, it's a bit too soon for that, yeah. I'd promised myself that, you know, up until at least sort of Christmas time, I'm going to try and have a go myself. And if it doesn't work, then, like I say, you know, then we'll drop back. And I think this season, the Premier League, we're going to see a lot of job changes, and then the Championship as well. You know, the money that's going to come into the Premier League next season means that owners aren't going to wait too long. And, personally, I think that's wrong. I think you need to get a coach and stick with a coach and give him the time that he needs to really stamp his authority and his philosophy on the team and bring them forward. But it's the nature of the beast we're in now. You know, I think in the Championship last season, the average lifespan of a manager was about 8-9 months, which is incredibly short term, you know. But that's the way we are, so we'll just wait.
And just to finish on that, I mean, would it be, especially as going into a managerial role, would you have to have the right person behind you in terms of the boardroom and the backing that you get? Because, as you said, some people are very knee-jerk. We just look at Leeds over the last, under Salina, it's been, was it 6 or 7 managers they've gone through over the last year? And
incredible.
It's remarkable, isn't it? I mean, would it have to be the right job for you, the right person, the right people behind you?
Definitely. There's been 3 or 4 jobs come up that I could have possibly got in the lower leagues, and I didn't feel it was right. I'd like to get the right club at the right time, but that's not always possible. You know, you can't sometimes pick and choose. At some stage, you've just got to go for it. But at the moment, I'm just waiting for the right opportunity, and when it comes up, I'll have a go. Now, that might be abroad as well. You know, this, like we spoke about earlier, about moving abroad and the different cultural aspects it takes. You know, there's the MLS now, which is a growing market, which is getting better and better and better. There's all of Europe. And there's even out here in the Middle East, which is getting stronger and stronger. So there's a lot of scope out there and a lot of things that I'm looking at.
Have you seen enough here to possibly tempt you to the AGL?
Yes, I have, yeah. I know Roy Aitken very well, who I think's a really good guy and very good at his job. And I think there's a really good standard. I think they're getting better and better. I think they're putting the money in, they're getting the right coaches, they're training right, practicing right. You're starting to get Middle Eastern players and Northern African players transcend across to Europe, and I think the standard's improving year on year.